Sitemaps, both HTML and XML sitemaps, are really important when it comes to SEO. Both have really important parts to play in helping Google understand and find all of your content. So, what are these two sitemaps and how do they work and what are the implications on your website's SEO? Well, I'm going to go through all of that and more coming up after this. Hey there guys, Darren Taylor of thebigmarketer.co.uk here, and my job is to teach you all about search engine marketing. If that's up your street, you should consider subscribing to my channel. Today, we are looking at sitemaps, both the HTML sitemaps and XML sitemaps. So let's go through and understand the differences between the two and the implications they have. An HTML sitemap is essentially a page containing a list of all the current pages on your website, including a link to those pages. So quite often when you go to a website and you look for a link in the footer, you'll often see a link called sitemap. And within that link, that's where you'll find this page. Now, an HTML sitemap is essentially just a list of URLs. It's just a list of pages and links to pages across your website. Now, the purpose of creating this is that when Google crawls your website, it makes it a lot easier to find your content, especially if your HTML sitemap is updated dynamically. So whenever you create a new page or a new blog post, when that list updates automatically, when Google crawls your sitemap HTML page, it will go ahead and find all of your new content. So it becomes quite an important place to put your files. And again, it's different to an XML sitemap, which we'll go on to later in the video. But if you can, create an HTML sitemap as the first port of call. It's the easiest thing to do. A lot of CMS products like WordPress and Drupal allow you to do this quite easily. If you're not too sure, as I always say, if you're not technically minded, speak to your web designer or speak to a freelancer or a consultant who could update this for you. It's quite an easy thing to do and an easy way to make sure Google can find all your pages when it comes to SEO. Now we move on to the more complex type of sitemap. This is known as an XML sitemap. Now, what is an XML sitemap? An XML sitemap is essentially a file built in XML that directs Google to find all the relevant pages of your website. It's basically like an instruction manual for Google to say, here are my pages, these are the pages I want you to find, these are the pages I don't want you to find, here's where you can find them, here's how often they are updated, and it's essentially a blueprint for Google to find your content. Sometimes you can create pages across your website that don't have anything linking to them in particular, but you still want Google to be able to find them and index them. Well, that's where you can define those pages within your XML sitemap and make sure Google can find them so they don't just have to rely on links to crawl your website and find all your content. Your main navigation and your links are the first port of call, but your sitemap can also instruct Google to index content that can't be found with the first attempt at crawling. On screen now, you'll see an example of an XML sitemap, and it's essentially an XML file, and in this instance, the one you can see on screen now is one I generated automatically using my WordPress CMS plugin, Yoast, which is a great plugin if you use WordPress. But if you don't use a content management system, you may have to generate a sitemap. So I've left a link in the description below that will automatically generate a sitemap for your website. All you need to do once you've done that is upload it to your website domain, and then you can direct Google to find that sitemap using the Google Search Console. In fact, I've created an entire course based on using the Google Search Console, and part of that includes optimizing your sitemap within there as well. So it can get quite technical, and it's very difficult to kind of go through and do these things sometimes when it comes to SEO, but it's still important you go ahead and start moving in the direction to do things in the right way. And creating and generating a sitemap and uploading it to your website is the first thing to do. Your sitemap should include a list of all the pages you want Google to find. And if you don't want Google to find a page, by not putting it in your sitemap, it doesn't mean Google won't index it. If Google can find it, they will probably index it. And in that instance, you need to tell Google separately not to index specific content. So the sitemap will help Google find pages, but it's not so good at disincluding pages and not including them in their crawl. Finally, I did touch on this just now in the video, but we're going to define how to tell Google where your sitemap is. The first thing you need to do is define your sitemap in your robots.txt file. Now, I've made a video previously about your robots.txt file, and I've linked that up in the description below, and you should define in this file where your sitemap is, so when Google crawls your robots.txt file, it knows where your sitemap is located. But there's a more important way to tell Google where it is as well. And again, I touched on this in this video as well, and that is to create an account with the Google Search Console and upload your sitemap locations there as well, because the Search Console acts as a bridge between your website and what Google understands of your website. So by linking your XML sitemap to the Google Search Console, Google will always know what the state of play is with your website in terms of what pages it needs to find and index. So it's really important to create that account on the Google Search Console and upload your XML sitemap to the Google Search Console. Again, I've made an entire course about the Google Search Console, and included in there is a way to show you how to upload your XML sitemap and manage your account there as well. And that is HTML and XML sitemaps in a nutshell. Now, of course, to generate your sitemap, again, as I explained in this video, it completely depends on the platform your website is built in. If in doubt, speak to your web designer, because this is a key technical SEO area you need to make sure you get right. So if you need help, definitely go ahead and ask for it. In fact, go ahead and ask me in the comments if you need help with your XML sitemap. And thank you for watching this video. If you liked it, please leave a like below. As I said before, in the comments, if you're having trouble with your sitemaps, let me know and I'll be more than happy to help. More important than that, don't forget to subscribe. Check out the other content on my channel, and I'll see you guys on my next video.